A very good morning, everyone. So let us solve one more problem on a cantilever beam subjected to two different types of loading. So the problem: determine the slope and deflection at the free end of the cantilever beam. Okay, the problem what we'll consider is a cantilever beam subjected to two types of loading. Let us consider one concentrated loading and one moment. So let us consider concentrated load as 30 kN and this external moment as 10 kilonewton meter. So the distances, this is 2 meters, this is 2 meters, and also here let us consider the moment of inertia as changing. Okay, so this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. Okay, so here there are two types of loadings. One is a concentrated load and one more is an external moment. If this is the case, how to find the slope and deflection? So as you are aware, so everything depends on the bending moment diagram. Okay, so when there are two different types of loadings acting, so one should be knowing, so you need to draw the BMD, that is bending moment diagrams, separately when two different types of loads are acting on the beam. So here one is concentrated load, one more is moment. If both the concentrated loads are there, then need not to worry, that is same type of loading, but two loads but same type. So if UDL is acting entire thing, nothing to worry. If two concentrated load, nothing to worry. If combination of UDL and concentrated load, then you need to draw bending moment diagram separately. Here also the one is concentrated load, one more is moment, so there is a combination of loads. When there are two different type of loads are acting in a beam, so then you need to draw bending moment diagram separately. So please make it a note. Whenever you come across a problem where two different types of loadings acting on a beam, so you need to draw the bending moment diagram separately. So everything depends on bending moment diagram, correct? The slope and deflection according to moment area theorem 1 and moment area theorem 2. So everything depends on the bending moment diagram. So whenever there is a combination of loadings, so that is nothing but different types of loadings, you need to draw the bending moment diagram separately. Okay, so it's not necessary to draw the elastic curve always. So if you want, you can draw it. So what are the things required? So slope and deflection at the free end, nothing but what is theta c, free end it is at c, and what is delta c, these are the things required. So to find this, okay, bending moment diagram, we need to draw it. So first what I will do, I will draw the bending moment diagram for only concentrated load, then I will draw the bending moment for the moment. So it is something like, so this must be equal to a cantilever beam subjected to concentrated load only. Okay, then one more, cantilever beam subjected to a external moment only. Okay, so this is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. Here the point B, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is A, this is B, this is C. This is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. Okay, so this plus this, both the figures. So this must be equal to like principle of superposition. Whatever the net effect will be, that must be equal to the effect due to this load plus the effect due to the external moment. Okay, so you need to draw the bending moment diagram separately for both the loads. Correct? I have kept the 30 kiloton load where it is acting at point B in the same figure. So again, the 10 kiloton load, that is external moment acting at the point C in the same figure. Okay, separate bending moment diagrams. The net effect will be the addition of both the things. Okay, that is principle of superposition. But one more thing what you need to understand here is the moment of inertia is changing. So from point A to point B, it is 2i. Then from point B to point C, it is i. So the what is moment of inertia? So if you have seen in engineering mechanics, so it is the property of a material, ultimately elastic property, what you can say, Young's modulus and moment of inertia. So if it is a rectangular beam, so ultimately if it is B, this is D, so moment of inertia is given by BD cube by 12. Correct? So this is related with the cross section of a particular beam, where the cross section is changing here, where the cross section is I only here. So that is the meaning of this. So whatever they have given, you can consider it. Sometimes they will give only like this, or sometimes the problem may be given like this. So this is I, this is 2i, this is point A, this is point B, this is point C. Either the problem will be given like this or like this. So you need to understand both the things. Okay, so A to B, 2i, A to B, 2i, the moment of inertia changing, nothing but the cross section of a beam changing, then here it is I. Is that okay? So let us draw the bending moment diagram now. So due to 30 kiloton load, so here this is free end, so there is no load, so moment at C is 0. So as you go from here, up to B, there is no load, then again moment about B is also 0. This load is acting exactly at B, there is no perpendicular distance, moment at B is also 0. Then when you come to point A, the maximum moment will be there at the fixed end. So at A, the bending moment will be 30 into 2, it is 60. So how to draw the diagram? So this is a straight line, so moment at C is 0, moment at B is 0, moment at A existed from here to here. So this is 30 into 2 is 60, correct? So here there is no load. So load started from point B towards A. So maximum moment at A. So this is negative diagram. So for cantilever beam, cut the section rightwards. If it is anti-clockwise, then it is positive. You are taking moment here rightwards. This is making clockwise moment. So it will be negative. And if it is anti-clockwise, then positive. But this is making clockwise, so it is negative. So we want M by ER diagram. So what is M by EI diagram? Divided by EI. Correct? But here, moment of inertia is changing from point A to point B. So B to C, there is no bending moment diagram. So we need not worry about this. Only from A to B. So M is 60 by EI. How much EI? 2EI. So I is 2I. So 60 divided by 2EI. I hope it is clear. M by EI diagram. I is 2I. So M by 2EI. So if I draw the bending moment diagram for this external moment, so now it is important. So this is a moment. So moment acting at the point B. So it is directly a moment, kilo newton meter. So from point C to point A, the bending moment diagram will be constant. Correct? So because it is directly a bending moment, external moment, it is not a force, such that you can calculate moment force into perpendicular distance. It is not required. So do not multiply again 10 into 2, 10 into 4, nothing like that. Okay, so it is a moment. So moment is nothing but it is already calculated force into perpendicular distance. So it will be constant. So sign convention, cut a section from rightwards if it is anti-clockwise positive. This moment is making anti-clockwise only, this is anti-clockwise, so it is positive. So how the diagram will be? So it is constant up to point A. So entire thing, it is a rectangle. Okay, so what is the value? So 10 kilonewton, 10 10. Okay, but you need to understand here, it is moment of inertia is changing. Where exactly it is changing? At point B. So if I draw here, so this is also 10, Okay, so understand this thoroughly. So from point A to point B, it is 2y. So point A is here, 10 divided by 2y. So at point B exactly, the moment of inertia changing. This side it is 2y, this side it is I. So if I write here, this side, left hand side, it is 10 by 2EI. Right side it is 10 by EI. So again at C it is 10 by EI. From B to C it is I. From A to B it is 2I. So this is point A, this is point B, this is point C. So this bend moment diagram is positive. Anticlockwise, anticlockwise, this is positive. This diagram is negative. So be careful with these positive and negative areas. Okay. So from here to here it is 10 by EI. From here to here it is 10 by 2EI. Is that okay? So net, let us solve the slope. So according to moment area theorem 1, what it says, the change in slope between any two points. Which are the points I need to consider now? One is point A, where theta A is 0 always at fixed end. So one more is at point C. They have asked at the slope at the free end. So this is theta C. So theta C minus theta A, where theta A is 0, is equal to area of M by ER diagram between A and C. So from point A to point C, which are the diagrams? So here one diagram is there, then here one more diagram is there. We have drawn separately since the different types of loadings acting on the beam. Correct? We need to add both the bending moment diagrams. So let us add it. So what is the bending moment diagram in between A to C? Only this. So which is negative. So minus. What is the area of this triangle? Half into base is 2 meters into height is 60 by 2 EI. This is minus. So when you come here, this is plus. So plus. So what is the area of this rectangle? So 10 by 2 EI, 10 by 2 EI. So base is 2 meters. Correct? 2 into 10 by 2 EI. Plus. What is the area of this rectangle? Base, that is again 2 meters, into height is 10 by EI. So 1, 2, 3. 3 different figures. So this area is, height is same. 10 by 2i, 10 by 2i, this is one figure. 10 by EI, 10 by, this is one more figure. Correct? Base into height. Base into height. Half into base into height. This is negative. This will be positive. If you simplify this, you will be getting, just a minute. So do this. So you may be getting 0. Check this. Do with respect to calculator. You will be getting this as 0. Okay. Do the calculation and check it. So the value you will be getting is 0. So next one more, that is according to moment area theorem 2. So what you need to find? So what is the deflection at C? So delta C, nothing but what? One more term, TCA. What it is? Tangential deviation of point C with respect to tangent drawn at A. Correct? From A. So you need to find the deflection, delta C. So this is what? Moment of M by ER diagram between A and C, and where the moment is taken? Moment is taken about point C, where the deflection is required. The first subscript indicates where the deflection is found. Correct? So now, so if I find the moment, so how many diagrams? 3 diagrams. CZ will be somewhere here. So from here to here, this distance I want, because I will be taking moment about C. This is the perpendicular distance. For this, exactly from here to here. For this center, from here to here. Correct? So let us do it one by one. So this area, area of this triangle, minus half into base is 2 meters into height is 60 by 2. Yeah. This is area. I want perpendicular distance, moment, moment of M by A diagram. So from here to here, what is the moment? From here to here it is 2 meters. From here to here, how much it is? 2/3 of 2. So from here to here it is 2. So total how much it will be? 2 plus 2 third of 2. Correct? This is for this. Then plus for this diagram. So what is the area? Base is 2 meters. Height is 10 by 2 EI. And perpendicular distance about point C. So from here to here it is 2 meters. From here to here it will be 1 meter. This is 2 meters. CZ will be exactly at the center. This is 2 meters. Exactly at the center means from here to here it is 1 meter. From here to here total is 2 meters. So this total will be 3 meters. Then plus for area of this rectangle. Base is 2 meters. Height is 10 by EI. And perpendicular distance from here to here. How much it is? CZ will be exactly center at for the rectangle. So total 2 meters. So it will be only 1 meter. Correct? So do the calculation and you will be getting around minus 50 by EI meters. Okay? Deflection, that is delta C, you will be getting minus 50 by EI. Suppose here they have asked only the slope and deflection at the free end. So we can calculate the slope and deflection at B also. If we are finding the slope and deflection at point B, so that is theta B and delta B if they have asked. If they have asked delta B and theta B, so what it will be according to moment area theorem 1? So theta B minus theta A, then area between A and B. So which are the area you need to consider? A to B this area, A to B this area. If you do it, some value you will be getting. So this is 0. You will be getting theta B. Just check it how much you are getting. Similarly, delta B. This delta B is nothing but tangential deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A. You need to take moment about B. So which are the figures? 1, 2. So from here to here only about B. Perpendicular distance 2 third of 2. So for this it is from here to here it is only 1. Only these two figures are you are considering. This figure you are not going to consider. So delta B and theta B, do the calculation. Here I am having the answer only for delta B. It is around minus 30 by EI. Okay. So here theta B means, so this area is there, this area is there, this area is not there. So you need to deduct this. So if you deduct, just check it. So how much you are getting? So that will be your theta B. So this is delta B. Please, whatever I am solving here, you do it once again. Write down all the problems. Okay. Problem statement. Draw bending moment diagram once again. And calculate how I have calculated once again. Then only you will be perfect. So otherwise, again, it will be difficult to understand the things. Okay, so here calculate theta B and delta B also, do not forget. Okay, so let us stop it here. So today what you have understood, so whenever there are two different types of loadings, okay, whenever there are two different types of loadings you come across in the same problem, so then you need to draw the bending moment diagram separately. Okay, so for this separately, for this separately, there might be two different types of loadings. One is concentrated load, one more is UDL, one more is UDL, and external movement, concentrated load, anything. So two different types of loadings. When you come across, then you need to draw the bending moment diagram separately. And according to principle of superposition, you need to add them. Okay, is that clear? So let us stop it here. We'll solve UDL problem in next class. Okay, thank you. So let us solve one more problem on cantilever beam subjected to two types of loadings. Okay, so next problem, a cantilever beam subjected to two types of loading. One load I will consider the moment, clockwise moment, 10 kilonewton meter. So I will consider the UDL, so that is 20 kilonewton per meter acting over a span of 2 meters. So again this is 2 meters. Okay, this is point A, this is point B, and let us consider this point as C. Okay, so a cantilever of total span is 4 meters. So there is a external moment acting clockwise 10 kiloton meter at point C, and from point C to point B there is a UDL of intensity 20 kiloton per meter. Okay, so here let us find what is the deflection at point B, that is at free end, and what will be the slope at point B, that is at the free end. Okay, so what is slope and what is deflection? Okay, so again, so whenever you come across two different types of loadings, what we have discussed, so two different types of loadings, you need to draw the bending moment diagrams separately, correct? You need to use the principle of superposition. So for this external moment, separate diagram. For UDL, separate bending moment diagram. Then the net effect will be the addition of both the bending moment diagrams, correct? So already we have solved one problem with respect to a moment and a concentrated load. Similarly, we need to draw it here also. Okay, only the bending moment diagrams will be different, correct? So this is a cantilever beam subjected to, I will consider only the moment, so 10 kiloton meter, 2 meters from here to here. So again, from here to here it is 2 meters. This is point A, this is point B, this is point C. Okay, this plus one more figure, what is that? UDL. I will consider only UDL, that is 20 kilonewton meter. This is point A, this is point C, and this is point B. So from A to C 2 meters, from C to B again 2 meters. So let us draw the bending moment diagram. So need not to draw the elastic curve always. So let it be, only the M by ER diagram ultimately we want. So due to this, what will be the bending moment diagram? So this is an external moment. We have discussed whenever there is a moment acting on the cantilever beam, that moment will be constant throughout till the fixed end. So here it is acting at point C. From point C to point A, the bending moment will be same, constant. So it is directly a moment, 10 kilonewton meter. So need not to multiply again 10 into 2. It is directly moment. So it is started at point C. So as we go near to the fixed end, so the moment remains constant. So at B it is zero. From B to C there is no load, so there is no moment. From C the moment started, from C to A the moment exits. So again, sign convention. So what is the sign convention? Cut a section from rightwards anti-clockwise if it is acting, then positive. So you are cutting a section here, the rightwards, this moment is clockwise. If it is anti-clockwise positive, this moment is clockwise. So bending moment diagram, so it will be negative. So this is negative bending moment diagram. So from point C to point A, the moment will be constant. It is an rectangle. So what is the moment? 10. So here also it is 10. Okay, so we want M by EI. Here again EI, it is constant. They have not mentioned. So moment of inertia is constant. So 10 by EI. 10 by EI. So negative diagram. Okay, similarly when you come to this, that is UDL. So again check it here. So it is not UDL subject on the entire span. So UDL is acting only on the span C to B. So how the bending moment diagram will be for this? Again, so it is started at point B. So exactly at point B moment will be zero. There is no perpendicular distance. So at point B it is zero. So as we go from point B to point C, the moment is there. Again from point B to point A, as we go near to the fixed support, the moment goes on increases. Okay, so here exactly at point B it is zero. What is the moment at point C? So this UDL 20 into 2, so if I convert, it is a constant load exactly at the center, 20 into 2 into 2 by 2, correct? So from here to here, the variation will be parabolic, only up to C, where the
UDL is acting. From point B to point C, the UDL is acting. Only the variation will be parabolic. So what is this moment? Exactly here, 20 into 2 into 2 by 2. So if you simplify this, you will be getting 40. Correct? So then, from here to here, again, moment is there, but A to C, there is no load. So it is, the variation will be a straight line. So this moment, what is this moment? So again, this load is creating the moment at point A. So 20 into 2, correct? So that is the total load acting here. From here to here, we want the perpendicular distance. What it will be? 2 plus 2 by 2. 20 into 2 into 2 plus 2 by 2. So total, if you simplify, this will be 120. Okay, I hope it is clear. So again, what is the moment exactly at this point? 20 into 2, a concentrated load here. Then perpendicular distance from here to here, that is from here to here it's 2, from here to here it is 2 by 2 center. So moment will be 120 by EI. So 120 by EI, this is 40 by EI. So again, so what will be the different diagrams you need to convert here? One is this, you know the area of this parabolic triangle. So here it is a trapezoidal. So we don't have the exact area. You need to convert into two figures. One is rectangle and one more is triangle. So what is this rectangle height? So already it is there here. This is 40 by EI. So again, from here to here it is 40 by EI. So what is this from here to here? So total is 120. So here to here it is 40. Remaining is 80 by EI. 120 minus 40, it is 80 by EI. From here to here it is 40 by EI. From here to here it is 80 by EI. Total is 120 by EI. Okay, so all the diagrams are negative. Correct? So now, according to moment area theorem 1. So what you are finding? Slope at B. So what is the theorem? Change in slope between any two points. So which are the points we need to consider? One is point B, where you are finding. One more is point A, where the slope is 0 at the fixed end. Theta B minus theta A is equal to what? Area of M by EI diagram between A and B. So now which are the figures between A and B? So here, between A and B, here one figure is there. Again, between A and B, 1, 2, 3. 3 areas, 1, 2, 3 areas. Again, here, one more area. So total, 4 areas are there. So you need to calculate area of all the figures. So what is the area of this? So all the diagrams are negative. You need not worry. Directly, we'll put negative at the end. So what is the area of this? Area of rectangle. So this is 10 by EI into 2, base is 2, 10 by EI into 2. So this is one area. Okay, let us consider this parabolic triangle. So plus, what is the area of this? 1/3 of base. Base is 2 meters. Here it is, into height. Height is 40 by EI. Correct? So again, plus this rectangle. So this rectangle area is 40 by EI into 2. So this is 2 meters. This is 2 meters. Correct? 40 by EI into 2. This rectangle. Plus one more this triangle. So what is the area? Half into base is 2 meters into height is 80 by EI. Okay, if you simplify this, so you will be getting total diagrams is negative diagrams. Everything is, if I put a whole bracket, it is negative. So you will be getting around 206.66 by EI. Okay, 206.66 by EI. This is slope at B. So one more thing what we are finding is the deflection at point B. Correct? Slope at B. Now we need to find the deflection at point B. So this is in radians. Write the unit. So now that is according to moment area theorem 2. What we are finding? TBA, nothing but delta B, tangential deviation of point B with respect to tangent drawn at A. So what it is? Moment of M by EI diagram between A and B, and moment is taken about point B where the deflection is required. Correct? So I will write here, I will start from here equal to, so this, so you are taking moment about B, this area into perpendicular distance, how much it is? So exactly at the center CZ will be there for the rectangle. This is 2 meters, so means from here to here it is 1 meter, from here to here it is 2 meters, so it is total 3 meters. Correct? What is the area of this? 10 by EI into base is 2 meters and perpendicular distance is 3 meters. One figure is over. Plus for this, where the CZ will be? Here. So from here to here, what is this? 1/3. So let me draw the figure once again here, it will be clear. It is parabolic and here it is straight line. So you have converted like this. Correct? So this side is 40 by EI. This side total is from here to here it is 120 by EI. So this is 40 by EI from here to here. From here to here it is 80 by EI. So you are finding the, these are the points A, C and B. You are taking moment about B because you are finding the delta B for this figure. CZ will be here from here to here. So area is for this figure, this is 2 meters, this is 2 meters. 1/3 of base is 2 meters into height, that is 40 by EI. Correct? Into perpendicular distance. So from here to here, it is 1/4 of L. From here to here it is 3/4 of L. 3/4 of L is nothing but 3 by 4 into L is 2 meters. 3/4 of 2. Okay. So plus this rectangle. So CZ will be here. From here to here, this distance you want. What is this distance? 2 meters. From here to here it is 1 meter. From here to here 1 meter. From here to here it is 2 meters. Total is 3 meters. What is the area of this? 40 by EI into base is 2 meters into perpendicular distance is 3 meters. Plus one more triangle area. From here to here this distance we want. So what is the distance from here to here? Base is 2 meters. From here to here it is 2/3 of span, 2 meters. From here to here it is 2 meters. So what is the area of this? Half into base is 2 into height is 80 by EI into perpendicular distance, that is 2 meters plus 2/3 of 2. Okay, so simplify this entire thing. So check with the answer. So you may be getting around total value 606.66 by EI. So that is delta B. 606.66 by I, which is negative. This entire thing diagram is negative. Okay, so just check with this. So do it once again, so you'll understand this. Okay, suppose if you are finding theta c, so the change in slope between two points theta c and theta a, you need to consider the only areas you need to consider this area plus this area plus this area. This area you need not to consider between a and c, 1, 2, and this one is 3. So check with that. So apply the formula. So you may be getting around minus 180 by EI. Check with this radians. So this is meters. Okay. So please go through this problem once again. So if you are having any difficulty, please feel free to contact me. So what is the task we are doing here? So there are two different types of loadings. Whenever you come across two types of loadings, so you need to have the bending moment diagrams separately. Okay, so I hope it is clear. So take down some assignments. So I will put these assignments once again. Take on this as the assignment problems. Okay, so I'll explain them. So but do it, okay, with respect to cantilever. Okay, so this problem, a cantilever subjected to UDL, but let us consider this is point A, this is point B, this is point C. Intensity of loading 10 kN per meter. So point A to point B is 2 meters, point B to point C is 3 meters. A to B, the moment of inertia is 2i. From B to C, moment of inertia is 1.5i. Okay, so whenever you come across a problem something like this, UDL is acting on the entire span. So no doubt here the type of loading is only one, but whenever you come across the moment of inertia is changing, so you need not to consider this as the entire as one. So again you need to split into two figures. So A to B 10 kN per meter. So from B to C 10 kN per meter. So this is 2i. So here it is 1.5i. Okay. So please split into two figures. Not only when there are two different types of loadings acting. Okay. This is a different case. Please follow this. Okay. Whenever you come across two different types of loadings, you will draw the bending moment diagram separately, but same loading but moment of inertia is changing, split. Okay, so if I draw the bending moment diagram, so from here to here it is only the load, so it is 10 the loading into 2, that is the base, into perpendicular distance is 1 2 by 2. Okay, so if you simplify this, so you will be getting 20 by, from A to B, the moment of inertia is 2i, 20 by 2ei, nothing but it is 10 by ei. This height is ultimately you are getting 10 by ei. Similarly, if I draw the bending moment diagram for this, so from here to here, UDL, parabolic, from here to here, nothing, a straight line. So what is the moment exactly at this point? So 10 into 3 into 3 by 2. Okay, so exactly here it is 10 into 3 into 3 by 2 plus 2. Correct? So from here to here it is 3 meters. From here to here it is 2 meters. So center line here, from here to here it is 3 by 2. So from here to here it is 2. 3 by 2 plus 2. Intensity is 10 into 3. So simplify this. So exactly you will split into figures. So whatever the value you are getting, that will be here. Total, this is minus this. This will be the thing. Okay. But exactly at point B, moment of inertia is changing. Correct. So this side it is the same thing divided by 2EI. This side it is divided by 1.5EI. So this is divided by 2EI. Here it is divided by 2EI. Okay. Please solve this. This is an assignment problem. I will post it once again. Okay. Let us stop it here. So next class we'll solve problem on simply supported beam. Okay. 2 to 3 problems on simply supported beam. So how to apply this moment error theorem. So let us discuss in next further classes. Okay. Thank you.